He's not gonna talk to
He's not gonna want to talk anymore. You were live. You're good.
You live?
I'm good.
Alright, so we're here with the top two teams.
She's smiling like a.
I need you guys to pay attention. I need you guys to listen up. We're here with the top two teams for the 2012 fall faceoff. In blue, from left to right, we have Greg, Joel, Savory, and Kia, the Crips. And Team Give Bud, Tiff, Blake, Teresa, and Siemens. Let's start off with one question. First to the Crips. What was your favorite workout of the day?
Heavyweight, son.
Yeah.
Heavyweight, son. Is this how you just said?
Yeah. Total was
that's heavy.
Total.
I like that.
I mean, I PR'd on a clean and jerk. You cleared your PR on a front squat.
You PR, what'd you hit?
275.
Nice, what'd you hit, Greg?
320.
320, nice. How'd the ladies do?
I like one, too.
Joel answered for us. You guys all like different work?
You like one, too.
You all do that.
Event 2 was probably the best workout of the day because it was just so close all the way to the left.
Yeah, you guys were close in every workout, probably first and second in almost every event.
Yeah.
So what was your favorite?
Except for Cindy.
And except for the strength, when you guys got first, we got like fourth and fifth.
Gotta work your weakness, Blake. What was your favorite workout, Team Give Bud?
I like the last one.
That's
because that's the one you remember last, Tiff. Let's be real.
That's
how Tiff's brain works.
I like all the ones
that's
that,
what we did.
I like all the ones that we won, which was like 4 out of 5.
Teresa, what was your favorite?
I don't know. I think the most fun one was 1-5. Was that the one with box jumps?
That was a fun one.
4.
4.
One four was fun.
That was fun, but I didn't do any handstand push-ups or very few.
Yeah, but you looked good standing there.
Thank you.
No, you did.
What did you guys think?
I did.
Blake brings up handstand push-ups. A lot of teams will complain that 100 handstand push-ups is too much.
No.
What do you guys say?
No, it's
just
you guys were done in 3.5 or something.
Really
yeah, he did 100.
No. But I mean, you guys were done pretty fast too, right?
Yeah, we weren't that far behind.
Yeah,
we
were catching them.
All four women were able to do a bunch of them.
At the end of all that volume, I think it was like less than a minute between our team and their team. So far,
so
it was close.
What would you say to somebody that complained about handstand push-ups being in that RX division?
Volume train them?
Work
on them or put somebody in your team.
Or start doing a scale.
Well, it's cool that they're in the RX team.
No.
So,
just train them,
it was close, right? We're 1 point. You guys were actually tied going into that final wall. Let's talk strategy. So, Greg's team elected to put a female in for the final workout, Fran, while Blake's team went with Kevin and Fran. What were you guys thinking? Let's talk the Give Bugs, Team Give Bug. What did you guys think going into that? Why'd you go in the order you went?
Well, I guess I'll take it. We thought that our females, our team is GiveBug, by the way, GiveBug.org. our females are, I think they're strong for females, so we wanted to put them out of
strong
the case.
Strong for humans, really.
Yeah, for humans. And so we just thought that they could separate against anybody else going in those two workouts out of the gates, just a little bit. And then at the end, Kevin and I are really, really similar in Fran. The difference between...
So you have a sub-2-minute Fran just like Kevin Seaman now?
Well, yeah, pretty similar, yeah. We're within like 10 seconds of each other. And in Elizabeth, he's normally better than me in Elizabeth with a squat clean because he's got a much stronger front squat than me. But changing it over to the power clean, which ends up making it a faster workout, especially with the ring dips, I thought with us being so close in Fran that he would be a better fit for Fran because we're within 10 seconds of each other. And then for Elizabeth, I think speeding it up without the front squats might have given me a little advantage over him, at least on the ring dip. So I think either way you swapped us kind of in those last two events, it probably would have been the same.
Who made the call for the Crips?
I guess it was consensus, yeah.
So what was your, would you change anything in retrospect?
Yeah, I think we would have put a guy in as Fran.
Think so? I don't know, we're working on
the thing
it.
Is,
shoulder injuries.
It was like...
You guys are the Crips,
yeah,
not because you're gang related, but because you're injured, right?
Yeah,
we've
all had it.
Are you gang related though? Because I know you are.
We're not allowed to talk.
I know you're ethnicity.
Dude, how much do I have to edit on this? Come on now.
Gang bang. What we thought was that their weight change would be really fast because they didn't have to. So we thought that if they were going fast enough.
Oh, don't film
me. Did
you get that?
No.
We got moved.
So, do you guys agree? Tell me, because I think 135 for men is harder than 95 for women. Do you agree?
Yes,
I agree. So
yes.
That makes sense
pretty
that you would put
We thought they would shine in those events way more than him and I.
And then the ring dips,
well,
you were limited.
Those
are
for me.
Well, right. All you were going to do ring dips, but you guys were probably a little faster.
Right. But like a guy can do, like my 1RM weighted ring dip is significantly more than theirs. Same 1RM weighted pull up. So it's a percentage. They're doing such a higher percentage of their 1RM for 45 reps. It doesn't make sense.
Can you talk for Give Bug from now on instead of like...
I was letting him take it. Thanks for wearing that Give Bug shirt.
Well, what was your least favorite workout of the day, Tim? She's his last one. Did anybody have one they just absolutely didn't like?
I thought the bar muscle ups were kind of circusy, but everybody had to do the same thing, so nobody had to.
I'm not gonna lie, Isabella's kind of a bitch.
How so?
I think it just gets heavy real fast.
Wait, what?
Right, but.
I agree.
You're allowed to dislike it, but do you think it fit well into the program? How'd you like
the
programming? Do you think it was a nice balance?
Yeah,
yeah.
I thought it was solid.
Yeah.
For the level of competition.
Right, I mean, it's an RX competition, but you have to take into account you're not getting games quality athletes, and you saw...
Thank you for that.
Not that you guys are, but that, you know, you guys are all... Blake was first place at LA CrossFit last year, although he was not on the team.
Dude, this is what I think at the end of the day. I think that our team is very different than their team, and at the end of the day, to come down after 4 or 5 events and be dead tied shows that the program was pretty solid.
So that the cream rose
like
to the top.
I think that our strengths
program.
Are different than their strengths. I think we were very different teams as a whole. You know what I mean? And to come out dead even going into the last event pretty much shows you that it was solid programming.
Cool.
I think.
Okay, let's ask everybody. We'll give this answer to be the last thing. After competition day, one thing you are going to work on to improve as an athlete. We'll start with Greg.
Just one.
Just getting stronger.
I gotta start taking more supplements than I already do, I guess.
Might even steroid. That's awesome.
What's the question?
What's one thing you think you need to work on now to become a better CrossFit athlete?
I think normally right now I'd probably go eat like a dozen apple cider donuts. And tonight I'm gonna try to cut down to 6.
So maybe nutrition.
You are a freakish athlete
for your nutrition.
My nutrition's better right now. I think it's pretty clear to everyone that I would just have to work on getting
stronger. Yeah.
Heavyweights for me.
How are all of you? There's 8 of you, 8 of our best athletes in Albany CrossFit Clifton Park. How's your nutrition? Would you guys say you're all dialed in? Because I know I can only speak. I speak to Blake and Kevin quite often. I think the ladies are actually better at nutrition than the men.
I think I made it to about noon. That's about.
I mean, we can be honest, what's real. So, answer do you want?
No, our other athletes to hear this and.
I'm pretty clean, like most of the time, but I'll also eat things that I really enjoy.
You wake up and have a shake.
How do you get those things?
My diet is a protein shake.
To order those things?
I do. I order a lot of paleo. Is that paleo? I order paleo on Melia.com. And no, I'm pretty clean. But
so
I do cheat. I cheat. No, I definitely cheat. I drink about it.
I was clean.
No, dude,
clean
I drink
year
every
and
day.
I started losing weight and I started losing strength.
You eat
and
cookies.
And now I eat junk food all summer and I eat strength gains.
Brownies.
The four. So you
wear
it
now.
You guys would never eat cookies, would you?
Once a month.
Once a cookie. I eat apple pie. I eat cookies. I had macaroni and cheese last night.
So that's not really encouraging our other athletes, our best athletes. What do you attribute that to then? Because
carb loading.
Fuel. Your body
just
takes
you guys. I mean, you guys also hit very hard wads regularly.
You just need that fuel. I can't eat enough.
Dude,
my job's pretty physical as it is throughout the day, so I come here afterward, I'm already beat.
Yeah.
So you gotta have something.
Do you truly think if you cleaned it up but ate enough fuel or calories to support what you needed, you'd perform better?
No, I don't think
I
ever
did.
I think maybe a little bit.
It's
stressful to eat clean all the time. This is stressful.
It is.
Enough. Job is stressful.
I think everyone
I'm
needs
not
all
knocking
the time.
Your answer. I'm not knocking
it.
I just want to hear your opinion. That's cool. Joel, what are you going to work on?
Oh, man. Gas tank all the way.
Right.
That's fine. I mean, I'm probably the strongest one in here, I'd say.
Yes!
Oh, come on.
It depends on what you're talking about.
He is catching up, man. You should see him during the day.
By the way, Seaman snatched 225.
I think everybody told everyone already.
What have you done for me lately?
All right, let's get the savory. Savory, What are you going to work on?
My video
both my gas tank and strength. I need them both.
You're gonna work on CrossFit.
She's so sweet.
I'm not that good yet.
She's very good. You're doing great. Just because Kevin was a bit faster than you today, that's fine. You did great on Friday. I meant that nicely.
God, that was mean.
Yeah.
Just my conditioning and getting back to.
How'd your shoulder affect your performance today? Because I think normally you would have been faster at Grace. Am I right?
Yeah.
So your shoulder, you being a little tentative because of your shoulder.
I think it was just a matter of me just being tired throughout the day. Because this is the first time I've hit something like this.
It was a lot of shoulders.
It was
a lot of
time you ran Grace.
It was a lot of shoulders.
I think it was
she held
showing
up
on that last Grace there, though. So.
Take some fish oil ice tonight.
Yeah.
Kev, what are you going to work on?
I think the biggest thing I work on just in general when you hit competitions is the mental stamina throughout the day. You know, like knowing when to turn yourself on, when to turn yourself off, when to rest, you know. So that's all it's very important to know.
Yeah, I got a lot.
Because it's not something you come across your day to day. Usually you leave here, you feel better, you feel energized, and you feel great. And then after the second workout, I felt terrible. So you need to know when to turn it on and when to turn it off. And, you know, that whole ebb and flow of the day kind of needs to get better with that. So.
What are you going
to
say, Joel?
Yeah, I noticed, like, you know, turning it on, turning it off, like, as we line up for, like, the last two events, you know, like, I see it all our faces. Faces are like, we're all yawning, we're like, oh, great. But, like, you know, we got out there, we got going.
So do you feel like, when, like, you and Kev are talking about, because I noticed a lot of teams, and I, you know, bringing up the handstand push-ups again, shaking their heads, and you can see they were defeated. Do you think the way you're talking to yourself before, during, after a workout plays a role?
I think you have your attitude, and it's like, you know, you just go and do it. You may not break records or anything like that, but you get it done.
So one of those, whether you think you can or you think you can't,
you're right.
Probably right.
Yeah. You get angry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't hear you yell that loud today, Greg.
No. I yelled pretty loud.
No,
he's loud.
I was trying to catch that on the mic.
I stepped back.
Does anybody have an embarrassing story that I missed? Anybody pee or poop the pants?
I went to the bathroom about 37 times today.
Oh, my God. In the box.
Pee a lot of nervous peas?
No, I was drinking a lot of water.
A couple of nervous peas.
Drink all my
nutrition.
Teresa, what are you going to work on?
Honestly, I mean, everything is kind of ongoing strength and whatnot, but for me, I need a muscle up.
We've been talking about that for some time.
We'll
get it. Let's make that our goal.
It's our goal.
Give me it.
Thank you.
Let's talk about you. You had a little injury a couple months ago. How did that affect your mental state?
I had shin guards, so I think that helped the mental state, but for me, it's like I didn't have the box jump gas tank that I would normally have. So I really didn't get to do as many. Thanks, Tiff. She helped me up.
60 in a row.
Yeah.
Did you do 60 in a row?
40.
And I couldn't. I just didn't have the...
It's a different movement if
you
don't do it.
Yeah.
Moving your body weight.
And I used to love box jumps and do pretty well.
Think you'll get them back?
I'll definitely get them back. Yeah.
Tiff, I need you to think long and hard.
Okay.
What are you going to work on?
I think just technique overall. Maybe some...
I did actually, Teresa whispered it, but I'm not here to pick on you. I noticed a chink in your armor today.
Chink
in your armor. Chink in your armor is an expression.
Not a wonder.
Yeah, you were looking a little goofy on those.
Thank you.
I'm not sure. I'm saying, let's be real. Like, you're
not.
It might have been 80 box jumps and 60 switches.
Yeah,
you weren't efficient.
Really? Yes.
You weren't as efficient as you could be.
I totally saw it.
Did you switch her up time?
I just fixed
her. I think she's good to go now.
She's good to go now.
Okay, let's look at those next week.
Jacket.
Yeah,
it's a nice jacket.
Yeah,
I like that jacket.
Who are you sponsored by these days? Is anybody your sponsor or just Tiff?
No, just Tiff.
Who are you sponsored by?
No way.
Amelia.
That's a long hat. You got to cross it. Any last words, guys?
No.
You guys all did great. Really proud of you guys. I'd like to think it's my coaching and the fact that I opened Albany CrossFit 5 years ago.
That does help.
I'm going to say thank you to you guys, the staff, and just putting the whole thing together. You look good.
He
looks good too over there, the guy holding the camera.
Behind the camera, love
you. Thanks to all you guys and the volunteers. It was cool. It's nice to have everybody here helping out.
Does anybody else want to thank us?
Thank the judges.
Have you guys fight with the judges?
No.
You notice like the better teams, not that all the other teams aren't very good, don't fight because it's like either your form is on or you're smart enough to realize. I saw teams fighting and it's like you're not doing reps right now.
Right.
You're just yelling at a judge and pissing them off.
Yeah.
A volunteer that's here for 8 hours. What's that?
Usually
you get less reps.
Yeah, less reps and pissing off somebody that's a CrossFitter. Like, we don't pay these judges, they're just CrossFit out. And a lot of them, the fact that they're not competing is because they're beginners or newer.
And they're dedicating a whole day, which is cool.
Yeah, that's awesome.
It's a long day.
So thanks to you volunteers that are watching this.
Absolutely.
All right, well, thank you guys. You guys did a great job. We'll look forward to seeing you guys improve on all those things you just mentioned. And thanks for sitting here after the competition.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.